So you've been hearing all this hype about the Leprechaun Lynx and are wondering what it's all about, or you're looking to possibly upgrade from the Sherman S. So I'm pretty confident in saying right now, the Lynx beats the Sherman S in every category. All right, I'll get into that in a minute, but let me first say that this is episode 2 of my Lynx season. So massive plans for Lynx coverage. Stay tuned for that. And of course, my regular analysis reviews, shorts, will be covered in the channel, and whatever comes up with the links that's unexpected, I'll be covering as well. So let's get stuck into the analysis. It's one of the huge factors, and the reason I'm so excited about this wheel is they've managed to pack all of this power and performance into a lightweight unit, just about the same as the pattern. That's just incredible. It's gonna make the balance better, acceleration, braking, range better, and the motor weight is just 700 grams more than the pattern. That's insane. Now, when it comes to comparison with the Sherman S, it gets a lot of things improved straight out of the gate. So I'm talking about, it's got the spiked foot plates, and that's obviously comparing to the Sherman S original foot plates. The jump pads come stock. The suspension fork cap covers are default included. And now I'm looking at the trolley handle, and it's positioned at the back and vertically raises. That should give better feel and control of the wheel. And that also makes a flatter top surface for the seat to go onto. Now you are going to have to purchase a pivot system for the seat, but I think once it's installed, it's going to have a bit more load bearing directly onto the chassis rather than onto the old trolley handle like the Sherman S. Now they've gone away from the Sherman S grab handles, and it looks more like the pattern, which is integrated bumper system with the grab handles. Looks great, gonna protect the shell. Now if we look on the inside of this unit at the battery covers, it looks more reinforced, and they've gone away from the Phillips head screws, which is great. Now we're working with Allen head screws. This is gonna be far better for maintenance and teardowns. And now to even get down to your battery level, this is improved in the electronics top cover. So it's double sealed, awesome durability improvement there for dust and water. And we've gone away from the Phillips head screws once again. Working with Allen head screws is gonna be far better to work on, guys. And that also means you don't have to expose the main board to connect and disconnect the battery. So less risk of shorting out or damaging the electronics, just far improvement over the Sherman S. Also, this controller is really beefed up. It can take massive current and power through it. It's going to give that safety margin that's just gives you confidence to ride hard. The higher voltage is going to give a greater safety margin at higher cruising speeds, so that's a big one. So once again, with the higher voltage, this kicks back into just default benefits at the same current, the 5 amps, it's going to charge a lot faster than the Sherman S. We're looking at about 4 hours with the stock charger. Insane. 7.5 hours for the Sherman S. What an improvement there. And we're given the option with the 50S cells. So this is a big topic. Check out my video if you haven't seen it already. I go into discussions here, but basically better in every regard except cost. So do it if you're a performance rider. If you're just chilling a bit slower, probably not going to notice the difference. So back to charging the Lynx, the charge ports have been moved from the front on the Sherman S to the rear on the Lynx. This is a big improvement. A lot of people were concerned about this. So looking at the eWheels website here, it says the improvements Leprechaun made to the pattern Sherman S outer seals and OBC rated. Two RZ bearings are used on the Lynx as well. So ABC is just means it's been certified, and the 2RZ means that it's weather sealed with a rubber gasket. So awesome work, Leprechaun, keep that up. There's some interesting features we're working with here. We've got the Overtorque protection. So if you just stalled motor, let's say you get a tree stick branch stuck into the mudguard and it jams the motor, it's not going to fry the controller. It's going to recognize that it's pulling too much current and protect the system. This is great. I mean, just think about the breakdowns you can avoid just with this one feature. And another one is a hall failure safety algorithm, meaning if the hall sensor fails on you while riding, the wheel's not going to drop you. It's going to keep going until you can come to a safe stop. Just another awesome safety feature, and this is what we need out of the EEC companies, just looking out for the riders. Now, I would like a bit more effort out of the app. My biggest request out of everyone besides InMotion, who have the split riding mode, which allows you to change how much the pedals tip during acceleration and braking. Gives you far greater control and safety, particularly on the braking. So let's get that rolled out, everyone. And speaking of the Lynx app, you have a more granular control now for the pedal softness. So 0 to 100, this is replacing your soft, medium, and hard modes. So a bit of improvement there. All right, so when I say better in every regard for the Lynx, of course, the Sherman S beats it on the battery size, but it looks like a really efficient system on the Lynx because we got the smart BMS system, 150 volt, 50S cells, more efficiency. So we're not actually sacrificing too much range, and I'll get to the range tests in a moment. So some of my ride feel complaints on the Sherman S that I'm expecting the Lynx to fix is that the Sherman S braking is just a bit too sluggish, and that really does slow you down because you can't safely ride at speed if you can't stop in time. So I've been hearing that in some ride reviews that it feels like it has more braking than the Extreme, and holy crap, that's a good sign because yeah, I've ridden the Extreme and it does pull up pretty quick. And I'm also finding the Sherman S is a bit top heavy, particularly with the Michelin Pilot Street 2 tire at lower speeds. So once again, that weight savings of the Lynx just going to be a huge factor. And that's one of the reasons everyone's so excited about this wheel. Just insane performance for the weight. Just a quick interlude to say, if you are in the market to buy a new EEC, use my code at eRiders for $50 off. And check the description for international buying options. Cheers, everyone. Also on the Sherman S, it's got the linear suspension travel. So I have the 62-pound spring for my riding weight, and I'm finding it is a bit jarring. Sometimes I crank the compression damping to zero just to get a bit more plush ride. I do like that, particularly when seated. I just want to not be jarred straight up into my spine. So with the Lynx, they're introducing a progressive shock system, meaning the top of the travel is going to be a bit spongier. When you go towards the bottom out, it stiffens up nicely. This is going to be a great compromise and should make it just better all-round wheel. You can cruise on the road. When you're hitting the trails and jumps, stiffens up, protects from that bottom out. Awesome stuff. And of course, we got the rebound and compression damping still. Oh, and on that note, the Sherman S and Lynx suspension systems, yep, they are the same size. You can put the Progressive onto the Sherman S. Amazing upgrade options now for you guys. And I'm ragging on the Sherman S a bit here, everyone, but you know, it's an amazing wheel still. Street cruiser, just EECs are moving so quick that we got these new wheels coming out that, you know, the specs are just better. Alrighty, so we have a big discussion in the community at the moment about the suspension weights. People are saying, should we go lighter? Should we go heavier spring on the Lynx? What do we do? All right, so as I said, for my riding weight, I'm going 66-pound spring on the Lynx. Now, this comes on two recommendations. Firstly, from e-riders saying, if I'm more of a street cruiser, want a bit more plush with that 66-pound spring. And now if I was doing jumps, I'd bump that up to 70 pounds. Looking at the Electric Dreams review, he responded to my comment saying he could ride 62 pounds, but I wouldn't. It would make for a super cushy ride after broken in. Too cushy. I'd just have to go with 70, even at your weight, especially if you're going to go off-road. Bare minimum, 66 pounds. So we're hitting that range of 66 for my riding style and weight. And for anyone unfamiliar, this is the internal coil inside the fork shock. And the primary effect of this is it's going to change the sag amount. So when you first stand on the wheel, it compresses a little bit, and that gives you suspension up and down over bumps. So the sag can be dialed in with your preload adjusters as well. So it's not end of the world if you're a bit off on your weight. So speaking of which, Marty Backe went 62 pound spring, and he's saying he has to go 50% preload to get the right sag at his riding weight. So that's a little tip for you guys, and that'll hopefully get you steered in the right direction. Alrighty, let's cover the range. So we are working with the 2700 watt hour battery here, down from the 3600 watt hour of the Sherman S. But don't stress it, as I was saying, more efficient system and lighter wheel makes it just sip at the power. So collecting some data from the other reviewers, we're looking at Electric Dreams reviews here. And with his riding weight, average speed, seems to be about 80 kilometers range. And looking at the draw rate of the battery, it's giving 34 watt hours per kilometer. Really good results there, everyone. Should be impressed with that. Similar result to my Sherman S, private roads, of course. I'm looking much higher at around probably the 39 watt hours per kilometer, and I'm lighter riding weight than him. So good start for the Sherman S. Looking at this post from Hanny Boone Boone, Lynx range test. Let's see, he's on the 50E battery cells from 100% to low voltage beeps, which is normally that 10 to 15% battery remaining. 75 kilograms riding weight. He reckons 80 kilometers range with 11% battery left. 30 watt hours per kilometer. Again, another great result. Doesn't say if it's GPS. Sometimes the GPS rating is 7% below the wheel odometer. Possibly a little less real world range there. Now, finally to Marty Backe, the godfather of EUCs. Now, everyone knows he's not a crazy speed demon. This is gonna represent more of your average riding style, and definitely even your group ride speeds aren't typically this fast. So let's have a look. Riding weight, 90 kilograms. And before he got to low battery mode, we're hitting 95 kilometers. That's pretty amazing given the average riding speed he maintained, 30.5 kilometers an hour. And one reason it's so efficient is his top speeds are only maxing out at 40, which is pretty chill, I can tell you, for this performance wheel. Now, once he turned on low battery mode, for anyone unfamiliar, what this does is it allows you to dip into the lithium ion cell's voltage a bit deeper. So you shouldn't do it all the time, can reduce your battery lifespan, but you know, to get you out of a pinch, roll home rather than the walk of shame, it's totally fine. He got 106 kilometers. This is an additional 11 kilometers range, insane range out of Marty's test here. Now, just a community question that comes up is, what about this max riding weight, 120 kilometers? So eWheels has you covered here with the answer. Historically, manufacturers used the stamped tire load as the limiting factor. So it's not actually based on a failure test of the, you know, EUC structure or pedals. It's just a baseline tire rating. So check out on the forums and the groups to get an idea of the stronger wheels out there. So given all these factors, this is why I'm confident in saying the Leapcom Lynx is better than the Sherman S in every metric. Cheers, everyone. Ride safe, and I'll catch you next time.